This is a geezer's perspective to the film Moonwalker. So the film Moonwalker was released in 1988 and it's got Michael Jackson in it. And this was like Michael Jackson's geezer period. This was like the height of like his creative peak. And this was when, like before like a lot of the controversy kicked off. Like around this time he was turning up to award shows with sparkly jackets, you know, he was turning up to award shows with Brooke Shields. He was very much like the Ric Flair of the music business at the time. So the film starts with Michael Jackson performing Man in the Mirror on his Bad tour. A few like bits of performance footage cut together. Then we cut to like some of his memorabilia on a table. Like there's hats, there's gloves, there's all kind of stuff. And then we see like a TV. It's playing like Jackson 5 performances and Michael Jackson music videos. And it flies into space and there's a dancing robot and all that. Anyway, then we cut to a replica of the Michael Jackson music video, or the Bad music video, but it's all the roles being played by kids, and they're all dancing around, you know, like the Bad video, but it's all being played by kids. And then after the music video ends, the little MJ walks off set, and he's acting like a right knob, you know, he's asking for a milkshake, and they're like, mate, we don't have milkshakes, and he's like, well, make me one then. You know, and he's acting like a bit of a knob. Then he walks through some smoke, and oh, it's Michael Jackson, you know, he's dressed in the same outfit, the Bad gear. And these animated tourists see him and they start chasing him around this film lot. And he sees these tourists chasing him, he legs it. And he wanders onto this Western set and his actors get annoyed with him. And Steven Spielberg, who's directing it, gets annoyed with him. You know, he turns into a dragon, you know, as you do. And they're all pissed at him, so they start chasing him. Michael Jackson's legging it. You know, lots more tourists just keep chasing him. He's like, oh, what am I going to do? You know, more people start chasing him. Oh, what am I going to do? And then Michael Jackson, you know, he hides in this wardrobe department. He sees a rabbit costume. That happens to be wearing exactly the same outfit that he's wearing. He goes, oh, that's a bit of luck, isn't it? Oh, I'll wear that. Oh, that's sorted it. Opens the door, walks out. Everyone's like, oh, it's Talking Rabbit. We see them every day. Oh, go away, I want to see Michael Jackson, where is he? He's like, oh, lovely jubbly, sorted this out. You know, walks over to a bike, nicks it, and whistles, all the tourists and all that will turn around, Michael Jackson does a kick and a spin, they go, oh no, that's Michael Jackson, the rabbit costume. So, you know, causing a bit of trouble, and then he gets on the bike, he legs it, he hightails it, literally gets on his bike. He goes out of the film studio, and we see a sign that the film studio is actually called MJJ Studios. So I don't know why Spielberg was annoyed at him. You know, he pays his wages. He should have been like, mate, I pay your wages. Calm down, mate. Anyway, he's driving his bike. All these tourists are chasing after him. Michael's bike turns into a motorbike. And he's going at a ridiculously fast speed. You know, he's going off. Yeah. And he turns into a traffic warden along the way. And he magics a stop sign. And, you know, he's giving people parking tickets. He turns into a builder and he points people the wrong way, then goes and overtakes them on that wrong way. You know, he's just playing around with people. You know, then his bike turns off to a jet ski. You know, it turns to a jet ski, flies off, and he gets his bike back and he pulls up at this desert place. He goes around this corner. You know, suddenly it was nighttime. Now it's daytime. Must have been a big corner that. Anyway, pulls up and he takes off his rabbit costume. He puts it down, you know, he's like, oh, that's that over with, right, you know, where can I get some grub, where can I get something to eat? And then the rabbit costume comes to life, and he's like, oh, what's going on, there's a rabbit, oh, what's happening? And then the rabbit, you know, changes into a dance-off, you know, and he starts dancing about, and Michael Jackson's like, mate, I'm Michael Jackson. He starts dancing around, Michael Jackson wipes the floor with him, you know, he spins around, and the rabbit's like, look, oh, right, yeah, you're Michael Jackson, you know, oh, yeah, fair play, mate. And then Michael Jackson gets tapped on the shoulder. And, it's a traffic warden or a policeman or whatever. And Michael Jackson's like, oh, no, what's he here for? Is he going to, you know, is he going to arrest me for the ridiculous speeding or impersonating traffic wardens? But no, apparently he's dancing in a no dancing zone. He's like, oh, you know, sign this here, mate. And Michael Jackson's like, oh, what's going on? He turns around and a rabbit's gone and legged it. It's gone and left him there to face the music. He's like, oh, I like that rabbit. What's happened to him? Oh, what a knobhead. And he's like, oh, you know, he's down. Turns around and he sees, like, the cliff behind him. It's turned into a rabbit, like, it's the shape of a rabbit. And the rabbit blinks at him. And Michael's like, the rabbit's got home safe. Oh, it's fair play, mate. All right. All right, see you later. Anyway, so we're almost, like, near the end of the film. And the main plot starts. Michael Jackson is with some kids. One's called Katie, another one's called Sean. Sean is being played by Sean Lennon, the son of John Lennon. Anyway, they're throwing a football around. They don't completely understand the rules of football, it appears. And Michael Jackson and Katie, they walk into this cave because, like, the dog wandered in there and, like, oh, mate, what are you doing? You know, they chase the dog in there, like, oh, come back, mate, and get back on with this soccer business. And they see this spider ingrained into a wall when they're in the cave. And they touch it and it opens up a door to a secret lair. And, like, oh, let's have a gander in here, you know, let's have a butcher's. And they wander into the lair and they see an evil villain who's played by Joe Pesci. And they see the dogs in there. And I overhear the villain going, oh, I want to sell drugs to kids, you know, all across the world. Let's hook them on drugs, yeah. You know, the villain's called Frankie Lateo. And Michael Jackson's watching this and Katie's watching this. And they're like, it's a bit heavy, that, isn't it? So Michael Jackson and Katie then give away their position. And Frankie Lateo, you know, he tells his guards, oh, who's that over there? You know, shoot him. Oh. Anyway, so then we cut to the present tense. It appears to be the present tense. And Michael Jackson, he's getting out of this building. And all these guards start shooting at him. They start shooting at him. And machine gun fires firing off, you know. Doesn't appear to wake anyone up. But everyone's shooting at him. And he gets out of the way into this sewer. And then he starts getting chased down the streets by Frankie's army. As I say, no bystanders around. Everyone's asleep. Michael's cornered. And he turns into a silver car that can also fly. And the car flies over Frankie's soldiers. It flies off. And then the kids meet up in some old club where Michael told them to meet, apparently. And they are sort of, like, you know, playing around on the piano, you know, just, like, yeah, having a gander around what it's like. And then the kids go in the old way, you know, going, oh, the club's a bit shit, innit? Oh, no wonder they closed down. So the kids hide in the alleyway. And Michael's car is being chased by Frankie's cars. And then Michael turns back into Michael and he's walking down the alleyway. And the kids are hiding, and then Katie peers over this wall and sees Michael. And she's like, oh, there's Michael. And they all have a look, and they see Michael walks into the club, and some light appears. And Michael walks in, and now suddenly the club's, like, transported back in time to the 30s, and it's open again. And Michael Jackson, you know, he flicks a coin into the jukebox, the Smooth Criminal music video starts. And, you know, Michael Jackson, he's dancing around and he's shooting people and he's breaking pool cues and stuff and breaking pool balls. And, you know, he's taking care of business, but he's doing it with style. He's doing it with style. Anyway, Michael Jackson, dancing around and all that business. He does the walk, the lean forward thing. You know, everyone's like, oh, how'd he do that lean thing? And the kids are watching it going, oh, how'd he do that lean thing? Oh, how's... Well, that's war. Okay. You know, they're watching at the window or something. You know, that's mad, that. Anyway, then there's loads of guards. Frankie's guards are at the window, and you can see silhouettes of them. And they start shooting at him. They start shooting up the gaff. And Michael's like, ah, I need to get out of here. And he gets out, and he sees the kids. And he sees Katie's not there. And it's like, where'd Katie go? Where's she gone? And they're walking down a dark street. Not exactly sure in the film where this dark street is. But suddenly a door closes and now they're trapped in some lair or something. And they're surrounded by loads of Frankie's soldiers all around the place. And two of the kids are watching, you know, from, like, a safe distance. And one of the kids, you know, he's saying, oh, you know, I'm wishing on a lucky star. You know, and Sean's character is saying, well, mate, why don't we just get the police? Why don't we get the old Rozzers and we'll sort it out? But he's like, no, I'm praying to start, it'll work. You know, leave me alone. Anyway, so Frankie, he's got this girl, Katie, and he tries to inject her. And Michael's like, no, don't do that. No, don't, no. And then, like, they knock him down. And then Michael, like, sees a star. And he turns into some giant robot, like, transformer thing. And he has force-filled shields and bullets and rockets and stuff. And he goes and kills all the soldiers. And he turns into a spaceship. And then Frankie gets away and the spaceship flies above the place. And Frankie gets into this massive missile shooter and shoots the spaceship, which is Michael Jackson. And the kids think, oh, Michael's done for, he's had it. And then Michael, still the spaceship, shoots Frankie. He's taking care of him. And the kids are sitting on the street corner. And they go, oh, you know, I miss Michael. Oh, oh, it's a shame. Oh, he's gone. Oh, no. And then one of the kids makes a star and says, you know, this is Michael's lucky star. And then Katie wishes Michael was back. And the star blows way up into the sky. And the silhouette appears in the smoke. And the kids run to it. And it's Michael Jackson. And they go back into the club. You know, Club 30s. And now suddenly it's like a backstage area. And Michael's like, oh, no, I want to show you something. And he gets onto the stage. He performs Come Together. He brings their dog as well out. The dog's not dead. And so, all's well that ends well. And then the end credits appear, and we see Story by Michael Jackson, which kind of explains this. So, yeah, Michael Jackson, one of a kind. Great performer, great singer, great songwriter. Not so great at writing films. Nice credit sequence though at the end. I quite like that. It's nice. That's my review. Moonwalker. Decent.